Drawing seashells is way easier than you think, and I'm going to show you exactly how you can do it, no matter your skill level.
Hello, wonderful people! It's Genevieve, and my goal here on the channel is to teach you all about illustration and design. So if you're new, make sure to subscribe so you don't miss any of the weekly videos, and so that you can join our wonderful drawing community. So grab your drawing tools, and let's get started.
So the first thing to do is obviously to create a new canvas. Now, the dimensions are totally up to you depending on your own project, and if you're not sure about that, I have a video that explains all you need to know in order to pick a canvas size for digital art. For reference, these are the dimensions that I will be using in this project, and the only reason for that is literally just because I'm painting in this pre-textured file that, as you can see here, has some paper texture to it. But don't worry, this file is absolutely not essential. So yeah, you could definitely do without it. And we're simply going to start by sketching. So no matter your canvas size, no matter if you have the textured file or not, go ahead and create a new layer and rename it to sketch. And it's gonna be a super simple sketch. I mean, this whole project is really easy. And for sketching, I like to go with gray, but you could use whatever you like. And in this tutorial, I'm always going to be suggesting two different brushes. So one brush is going to be a free brush that comes with Procreate, and that's going to do the job really well. And the other brush would be a brush that you could use if you want to pretty much just up your illustrations to the next level, get results that might be a little bit more professional. So here you could either use the HB pencil in the sketching panel, or if you have my big brush bundle or the watercolor brushes, just pick the coloring pencil. Honestly, for the sketch, the brush really doesn't matter because we won't see it in the final result. And just start by loosely drawing a circle to kind of map out where your shell is going to be. And then you're going to draw this V shape in the bottom to actually map out a little bit more clearly the shape of your shell. And you can see here, I'm not being precise at all. And I recommend you do the same, because this sketch, again, we just kind of want to map out where everything's going to be. And once you have this kind of inverted cone shape, go ahead and add this little bow tie situation on the bottom. And that's really pretty much it. We only have to add these little sunray lines, I guess. I'm not exactly sure how you would call them, but these lines so that when we move on later to the color, we have few guides. But again, no need to be precise. This kind of sketch is definitely good enough, and you can just move on once you have something like this. So once you have your sketch, go ahead and create a new layer and put it below the sketch layer. This is where we're going to paint the color, so you can rename it to color or seashell or something like that. And you might want to actually change the blending mode of your sketch. And to do that, you're just going to click on this layer, click on the N, and apply it as multiply. And you might also want to lower the opacity until you can just barely see it. Now, going back on your color layer, you're going to pick the color you want your seashell to be. So in my case, I'm just gonna go with this coral pink, but you could really use any color of your choice. And now check this out for the brush. So if you don't have watercolor brushes, you can go in the airbrushing panel, pick the hard brush, and then lower the opacity, which is this little slider here. And you're still going to be getting some sort of an overlapping overlay effect that is going to allow you to get watercolor results in the end. You're not going to get the texture, of course, but I'm going to show you a few tricks on how you can still make your piece look a little bit like watercolor. So that is an option. If you have my watercolor brushes, which by the way will be linked in the description below along with a special promo code for the YouTube people as usual, just go ahead and pick the Dark Edges watercolor. And at this point, you're going to color in all the little elements individually. So here are the two sides of the little bow tie, and then kind of all the little section of the seashell one by one. And the reason for that is, since we're using brushes that either have transparency because we lowered the opacity, or watercolor brushes, we're going to get these great overlaps. And since we're drawing all the sections individually, as you can see here, whenever we kind of draw two side by side, we get this overlap in between them, which is going to start building the watercolor effect. And also it's going to help get this kind of seashell texture and surface on it. So that's a really quick way of starting to build, like I was saying, the watercolor effect and the three-dimensional aspect of our seashell. And this is also not a step where you have to spend a whole lot of time because we're actually going to go in and blend everything in together. So you can also hide your sketch at this point, we don't need it. And for blending, you have a few options. So you can either use the smudge tool here and setting the smudge tool to, again, in the airbrushing panel, if I can find it, there we go, the soft brush. Or if you have the watercolor brushes, you would set your paintbrush to the water drag. I know usually it's a water blender, but this time we're using the water drag. And what you're going to be doing is you're going to drag the color downwards with little strokes. And that's pretty much kind of mimicking adding some water on some real life watercolor pigments. So you're just going to be getting this kind of blend and this gradient effect that is not super, how can I say that? You know, it's not perfectly smooth. You are going to be getting some imperfections that will look like watercolor, especially if you have, again, the water drag. If you don't have the water drag, you are going to need to use your smudge tool in a way that is a little bit random. And what I mean by that is you have to purposely create these imperfections in your blending. So you don't want to create a perfectly smooth gradient that is not watercolor-y at all. You do want to have something that looks a little bit messy like this. And don't worry, we're going to make it look less messy in the next few steps. But for now, you do want to have some textures and some splotches and some random color things happening. And guys, if you've watched this far in the video, please go ahead and comment the word beach. I know it might sound crazy, but it gives me a lot of insight into how to edit my video and how to pace everything so that I can create just better tutorials for you guys. And it's also really cool because you guys know me, but I don't know you. So whenever you leave a comment, I get to see your name, your username, sometimes even your face. And that's really great to just see the wonderful drawing community that we're building here on this channel. So go ahead and leave a comment with the word beach and we'll keep going. So once you feel like you have enough color gradients and stuff happening on your piece, we're going to go in with the eraser and setting it to the soft brush again from the airbrushing panel. Everyone, no matter if you have the big brush bundle or not, and we're going to add a little bit more light because right now this is a little bit flat still. The way to draw light is basically you're going to go between your darker sections and add two or three lines. So make sure to peek at the video because this explanation was not necessarily the clearest, but you're going to see really quickly what I mean now. And again, this step is not a step where you have to be precise. We're going to go in later and blend these erased strokes in with the rest as well. But all you want to do here is kind of try and make your illustration balanced and bright and just a bit more interesting than it was before. So again, nothing complicated here, should not take too much time. And once you're done, we're just going to go back to the tool that we use for blending. So either the smudge tool or again, the water drag. And same thing, you're just going to be dragging your strokes downward with tiny little strokes. So this is really going to start building your shell in a way that is going to be watercolor-y and just overall interesting. And again, if you don't have, you know, the watercolor brushes or the water drag and all those things, that is totally fine. It's just probably going to be taking you a little bit more time because you're going to have to be intentional in making it look messy, if that makes sense. But there is one little trick that I can give you to help you with that, which is if you use the selection tool here, setting it to freehand, you can draw this absolutely completely random selection. As you can see, there is no rhyme or reason to what I'm doing, making sure that you close it. And then you can feather the selection somewhere around, you know, between 20 and 30%. Now, look at that. This is really cool. If you go in the magic wand here, using hue saturation brightness to the entire layer, you can play with the hue, which is going to, if I go crazy, as you can see here, change the color of your shell. So this is a technique that I recommend using even if you have the watercolor brushes, but if you don't, that is definitely going to be helping you in creating those random spots of colors like I was talking about earlier. And you can repeat this technique 2, 3, 4, 5 times, as many times as you want, to create some randomness in your color and just more color variation in general, which is going to mimic what real watercolor pigments would be doing, you know, in real life, on real paper. You would usually not have something super flat and uniform. You would be getting some randomness in the color. So that is a really good trick to use. And you can also use a trick, again, the selection tool set to freehand, but this time making a selection that is a bit more like a half moon shape towards the bottom of your shell. Again, you would feather it using hue, saturation, and brightness. This time you would lower the brightness. So instead of playing with the color, you would actually play with making it look darker. So that's a way of adding shadows and making it feel like there's a little bit of light in your piece. And this is also a tool that you can use to add some patterns on your shell. So without a selection this time, use saturation brightness, but pick pencil. And this is going to allow you to create, like I was saying, patterns, kind of like these stripes that I have here in my example. So everyone, go ahead and pick the, in the airbrushing panel, the medium hard blend brush. And for now, don't worry about the settings at the bottom. All you're going to do is map out your pattern. So I'm going with these little stripes, like I was saying, but you could add little dots or, I mean, that's pretty much it, stripes and little dots, but you can definitely experiment. And I like to go in first with just really hard strokes, or pressing really hard on my pencil, I should say, because this medium hard brush has kind of two functions. If you press hard on it, you're gonna get really sharp edges. And then if you press super lightly, it basically becomes a smudge tool. So at first I like to just map out my pattern while pressing really hard. And once I kind of have a rough idea of what my pattern is going to look like, I go in and then play with the settings. Usually I tend to put the hue right in the middle so that it doesn't change. And I mostly just play with the saturation and the brightness so that I get stripes that are either lighter or darker, but the same color as my shell in general. And once I have a color that I like, I just go in and kind of use, especially for stripes, you would not do that for dots, but I use this brush by pressing really, really lightly. Like I was saying, it becomes a smudge tool. So you can create really quick, super easy gradients this way. And what I like to do, like you're seeing here, is I just kind of stretch the color towards the top. So I have one hard edge in my pattern, and then the other edge is just blended towards the top and creates this really cool gradient. You definitely don't have to do this. You could have a pattern that is, you know, two hard edges, but you can experiment. And with this brush, it's super easy, super quick. And you can see we completely transform our shell in just a minute, maybe two. So it's super easy, super simple, super fun. And all we have to do really now is to add a little bit more details and a few final touches. So go ahead and create a new layer, renaming it to Details. And for this one, you might want to change the blending mode. For now, I'm going to set it to Linear Burn with the opacity at 50%, but I'm going to come back to that later. Now for the brush, you can just go back to the one that you use for your sketch. So either the HB pencil and the sketching panel, or the coloring pencil from the watercolor brushes. And here really all you can do is just add these extra sharp and crisp little lines to give a little bit more texture and details to your shell. Because right now we're drawing something that is watercolor, so everything is really soft and kind of blended together. But it looks really cool, I think, to add these little details, especially in the bow tie, just kind of making the piece feel a little bit more finished and polished. And again, this is another step that, you know, is fairly easy and doesn't take a whole lot of time. I mean, this entire tutorial is quite easy and quite quick. But still, when you take all the steps and put them together, it creates this really cool piece that, you know, this can be kind of impressive, if I do say so myself. So anyway, once you're done, you can change your blending mode. I'm personally going to go with multiply and up the opacity quite a lot, but feel free to experiment here and find something that you like. There's really no rule at this stage. A few more things that you can do. You can create a new layer, renaming it to Splatter and changing the blending mode. This time we're definitely going to go with Linear Burn and then we're gonna stick with that, but we're not going to lower the opacity. And you can add splatters. Now for the brushes, if you had the watercolor brushes, simple, you just use the splatter brush. Otherwise, if you go in the spray painting panel, you have this G Clay brush here, which looks like splatters, but it's a bit dense. And you also have this splatter brush, which I mean, I don't even know what to say about this one. So those would be two options, but I definitely recommend if you have the watercolor brushes to just use the splatter brush because it was made for that. And you can see here, it takes 2 seconds and it adds some really cool splatters. Now, one thing that you can do as well if you have the watercolor brushes is to go back on your color layer and pick the salt brush. Now, there's no alternative that comes with Procreate for this brush, sadly, but it's a cool brush that allows you to add a little white speckles in your piece. So just starting from a white part of your canvas or a transparent part of your canvas and dragging the brush inside your color. So think of it kind of like a smudge tool. It doesn't have any color to it itself. It's just moving the color around. So if you start from a transparent part and then bring it onto your color, it's going to bring some white. And I have a final little tip for you guys, which is how to add some texture in your piece. So for this, I'm going to be using the watercolor splotches that come with my watercolor brushes, but it works with most textures. So what you would do is you would locate here in this French icon menu, the add option, and you would click insert a file. If you have the watercolor brushes, just locate the watercolor toolbox or big brush bundle or whatever and find the splotch in PNG. Otherwise, just locate the file you want to use. And the color doesn't matter at all. Just try to find something that you like the texture of and then just click import and it's going to be placed as a layer on top of your art. It's probably going to look crazy, but don't worry. Just go ahead and click on the blending mode selection and change it to color burn. We're then going to go back to our trusty hue saturation brightness panel to the entire layer and we're going to lower the opacity, or sorry, the saturation all the way down, which is going to make this layer black and white. And now you can just play with the brightness setting until you get something that you like and you can reposition using the arrow tool until you get your texture to be exactly where you want it to be. And you could repeat this step with as many splotches or as many textures as you want and just, you know, place them wherever you want them to be on your piece. You can also play with opacity until you get something that you're really happy with. But yeah, that's a really super simple, quick way of adding textures to your illustrations. And if you enjoy drawing this seashell, but you now think that it looks a little bit lonely, I highly recommend that you go watch this video in which I'm going to teach you how to draw a jellyfish so that your seashells has a little marine friend. So just click on this link right here and I'll see you there.